Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Happy new month to you all. I think it's the first day in February, so hope you are smashing those goals you set for yourself. 2018, first part of the month is gone already. So today I'm going to be doing a video teaching you guys how to edit a footage with using LUTs. LUTs are lookup tables. They are some sort of code in a software that actually picks out which exact colors you want your footage to look like. So it's more like Instagram filters but for videos in some sort. So I'm gonna be doing a quick tutorial on how to edit. I'm gonna be using Final Cut Pro because that's what I used to edit most of my footage. So I'm gonna be using LUTs in Final Cut Pro to edit some footage to show you how it goes. My hair is actually pretty scruff because I've not had time. I've been working through. Let me just call it. Ignore the weed sign, by the way. And I also got these shades from House of Brunettes. You can check them out. I'll link their IG page below. Some of you might wonder why I'm wearing shades. I'm wearing shades because I have this problem of when I'm looking at the camera, I tend to look at myself because I'm recording my phone. So if I'm wearing shades, then my eyes wouldn't be shifting between both. So let's go into the editing straight up. I'm pulling up Final Cut Pro. That is my Final Cut Pro. So let this load up. So the next step will be to start a new project. I'm going to name this project LUTs Tutorial. Okay, 1080p HD. Resolution is okay. Frame rate. Let's put, since I'm not doing any slow motion, I'll put the frame rate at 30p. I actually live in Yaba, so that's why there's a lot of noise. This place is noisy. Lagos is noisy. Fuck. So let's go into the, this is my timeline more or less. This is where you edit, this is where you drop most of the clips. This is where you import footage. This is what shows when you're on the screen. And these are effects for changing one or two things. Like I said earlier, you can either import using this click button at the top, then you just go to your desktop. I put most of my footage, I put it on my desktop. So you can just go to footage and you can edit. You can just drag it in and use this button here, import. Or another way of doing this is, which is my personal favorite, you can just go to your desktop, click this, copy, and drop it here. Finish. So you wait for some seconds for it to render. It's rendering here. Okay, it's importing. And you wait for some seconds for it to render. Depending on your system, depending on the kind of system you use, and depending on the processing power, that will determine how long it takes to render. Let's see, this is our clip. I have two drone clips here. Let me just lift this from the timeline to... differentiate. So I lift from timeline. So now I think we can spread them out. I think I use my command and B to cut, or you can just click B and just cut like this. Everybody has their own different ways of editing, but this is my own workflow. So these are the footage I have. I want to separate them using each block of storyline. Put this here. I put this here. So I think it was an Acura or something. So this is a drone clip of a drone taking off. and an overhead shot of the drone taking off too. This is also another drone clip at the beach in Akure. So let's go into the editing. The first step you need to do is you need to have a base correction to correct any exposure, to correct your exposure. Exposure is the first step. That's what I actually do. So you go to your this tab that has the titles. You take your base correction and you drag it into your timeline over this footage. Drag it to fill up the footage like this. It's directly over it. Then it renders. I think to make this faster, let me just do it this way. Don't need this long. Drag this to make it shorter. Don't need that. So yeah, this is our timeline. Yeah, I don't think we need. Where does the action start with this one? Yes. Let's reduce the size of this clip. It's too long. So. I think while it's rendering, let's cut. I just cut all these footage now. I cut the base correction. I want to have each clip of the base correction over each footage, so that each base correction is meant for one footage. So remove, we click this, click this, click this, and we delete. So they are not connected in any way. We have to wait for it to render. This takes some minutes based on speed ups. I believe the footage is done rendering according to this place, so we can go to the first place. What we need to do is we click on this first base correction. That is this base correction. Then we add in a color correction tab from under the installed effects. So drop that here. Then go to the color board. Then we click exposure. Then we go to show video scopes under view. We're currently showing this video as a little bit underexposed. This white tab is to increase the exposure, and this one is to bring down the shadows. So I think based on the time of the day, if we increase it a little bit, what we should try to do when we are trying to increase the exposure, we should make sure it's not the first, the peaks are not hitting 100. And the shadow is not going below zero, if not, you start to lose detail in your footage. So let's just increase this a little bit. Then the shadows, we bring it up a little bit too. And if we play this, what looks like. So there's a lot more contrast between the footage. So if we play this, this is what it looks like. And so this is before. See how dark it is? This is how dark it is. And this is after. See, it's a lot more brighter and there's more detail in the footage. So we do the same thing for the other clips. We drag this in. Go to video scopes. Exposure. View video scopes. Then bring it down. So the major thing is to just keep it between 100 and 0. And do the same thing for the next one too. Drag it in. This is actually an iPhone footage. Then exposure, increase it a little bit, bring down the bring down the shadows. Then the third one, this is a Nikon footage, I'm guessing, and bring it up and take this down. Another thing to remember is to get the best color graded footage, or to get the best results when using LUTs, it's better when you shoot flat. That's in log format for Canon cameras. My first two footage, I didn't shoot log. Or C log, you can shoot C log for drone. I didn't shoot log. So there's some colors already from the camera. So I think we're done. Wait for it to render. So I believe we're done with this. So we go back to our title tab and we look for look great. This is, I think it's called adjustment layer in some, and I don't know what it's called in Premiere Pro, but it's called look great in this way. You could do LUTs for Final Cut. So let me zoom in a little bit. Then I take this here, drag this here. Since I'm going to be using the same look great all through, so the next step would be to go to my effects. So for effects, I think I'll go to MLUT under effects. I'm going to do a different video on how to get this MLUT into Final Cut Pro. That one's going to be a separate video. So, but for now, if you have MLUT on your, I doubt you would have. So I'm going to do a separate video. If you have MLUT, just take this MLUT, drag it into your look grid. Then we can close all these ones. So when you drag it into your look grid, you close this one too. So now we have the MLUT here. It's under our effects. So it has all the levels and all. So the next step will be to load the LUTs. I'm also going to do a different video on how to get LUTs free of charge online. So you go to, we don't have any in the library, so we just go to custom LUTs. I have my LUTs on my desktop. We pick. These are the LUTs I have. I have Aspen, I have Humble. This is Humble. This Humble is the one they used to get the look of Humble. Kendrick Lamar's Be Humble.
Wicked or weakness, you gotta see this. Yeah.
Then some other ones. So let's use Humble. Let's see what Humble can get us. Then for this one, I think this VLT is for, no, this is for Premiere Pro. This VLT, I don't know what it's for. Then Cube is the one you're actually gonna be after. That is the one used for Final Cut Pro. Then let me increase this a little bit. So there are three in it. There's Log, Humble Log, there's Standard Cube, and there's VLog. VLog is, I think, very heavy. Log is just medium, average. Then Standard is gonna be just light. So most times I just prefer using Standard because it's actually easier to increase or reduce since it's just a little bit light. Then we load this into our timeline. So when we load it, we can now decide to adjust based on our preferences. If you look at our footage now, it's going to be totally different. It's going to be totally different from what we had. Yeah, I think for this first footage, let's see. This is without, and this is with. So I think for the first footage, it's looking a little bit too much. Let's reduce the intensity. Best place to start is start at 50 so that you can either increase or reduce. So I've reduced it a little bit to 50. Let's look at what it looks like now. If you reduce it totally, this is it. Fully, totally. And you can also work on the highlights, the mid-tones, either to reduce it or increase, and you can work on the shadows, just like the LUT, based on what you want to achieve. So this is what it looked like before. I think a little bit, let's increase the saturation a little bit. Yep. So it's a lot greener now. Then highlights. Let's make it a little bit brighter. Add more of the LUT. So now this is what our footage looks like. And this is what it used to look like. Now this is what it looks like. For the next one, this is the beat shoots. This is what it looks like now. And this is what it used to look like. See the difference? Like the sky is way, way bluer. It looks so buttery, it looks so smooth. It looks so, this one, I don't even think I need to touch it anymore. Or maybe just increase the brightness a little bit. Reduce the LUT a little bit. Increase the saturation a little bit. Then shadows. Less shadows. Increase the mid-tones, make it a little bit brighter. So now we have that. So let's move to the other one. There's this one. This is the iPhone footage, and it looks totally way different from what it used to look like before. This is it before, and this is it after. Before, after. It's so much different, there's so much definition in the sky. And now then let's move to the last one, the final one. That is the car footage. This is what it looks like before, and this is what it looks like now. There's so much difference in actually what the footage looks like when you're editing. So this is what most of all those music directors and music video directors actually use. Because now, like, technology has made everything easier now. You don't need to start picking out each color. You can just get a LUT and put it on your footage. So just to wrap this up, let's just look for some nice music. Let's use this one. So we detach audio. I use KC. I'm gonna do another video where I get my music from too. It's a lot of content coming out. So if you're not subscribed, better subscribe. Try subscribing to the channel. Please, thank you. So we delete this. Then let's put this over. Let's hear the sounds. Okay, so we cut this out. The best songs to use for your videos, I try using non-copyright songs. So let's do this. So we'll play our footage now. This is what it looks like. Let's replicate this over all our clips. So let's play it now and see what it looks like. There's a lot more definition in the footage. Take it to the next sleep. This is the final one. Let's take on the last one. See the definition of the sky. So there you go, guys. Now you wait for it to wind down. I'm just rushing this because I just want to get this out before. So you wait for it to render, then when it's rendered, that's all. that's what I have for you guys today. So you guys can try out some of what I actually mentioned, and if you have any questions, you can always ask me in the comment section below. If you also have any new ideas for what kind of videos you want me to be pushing out, also talk to me in the comments below. So that's all for today. See you guys next time on my channel. If this is your first time on my channel, please subscribe and hit the like button if you like my videos. See you guys next time. Peace out.